Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Nastasia. If you're new here, I would love it if you would subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. For today's video, I'm sharing with you guys simple ways that you can make your home more relaxing. I know a lot of us are spending a lot more time at home, so I feel like this is really important. And for me personally, I have worked full-time at home for the past 10 years actually. So it has been a long time. I've learned a lot of things that work and don't work. So I wanted to share with you guys everything that I find that really, really works for me. So without further ado, we can just jump right into it. So the first tip, I know I've talked about this a lot before, but definitely less is more. Living in a more clutter-free environment is going to help tremendously. And I know a lot of people when I talk about this are like, but your place is perfect. Like, trust me, like I had to hit rock bottom in the clutter space to really get things together and get things in order. When I first started YouTube, you couldn't make any money, so companies would make up for that by sending free product in exchange for promotion. And it got to the point where I had so much stuff. It was kind of ridiculous. I was living in a house at the time and I had two separate closets that were just like overflowing with things. I had packages and stuff all over the house and all these different things and stuff that I was just like buying to try out. Also, that was just so unnecessary. Basically, a clear space is just going to result in just a clear mind. It's really hard to focus when there's a ton of stuff around you. So I would really encourage you guys to declutter. It's helped me tremendously and I know it would help you also. The next tip is to have plants around your home. If you are new to the plant space, I would recommend starting off with one plant and then working from there. It can be a little bit overwhelming if you get a ton of houseplants all at once. Overall, they can improve your health as well as the air quality in your home. It also gives you something relaxing to do. For me, going around, checking all the plants, misting them, watering them, it gives me something to do that is very just like relaxing and very therapeutic, in my opinion. So that is something that you can do that's obviously going to make your home more relaxing, as well as give you something to do that might relax your nerves a little bit. For me, I feel like I've moved into more liking plants and having less like decor around that doesn't serve a purpose, because for a while, I feel like I was going a little overboard with the decor, and I know with this new space, I definitely didn't want to do that. Research also says that indoor plants can improve your concentration and productivity, which is great, because now that we're all working from home, everyone can benefit from that. The next thing I wanted to share with you guys is having a dehumidifier in your home. It is very important, and I feel like it's something that not a lot of people talk about. I don't really hear people talking about dehumidifiers at all. They are very important and very essential for your home. They can actually work to remove a lot of allergens that occur in the home, especially like dust mites, mold, things that sometimes are growing or all around your home and you don't even know it. So I'm gonna share with you guys the dehumidifier that I have been using recently. So this is my Dia dehumidifier. It has a lift and twist design and it will help protect your space from, as I mentioned, mold and mildew that can develop due to excess moisture. So this one in particular has a 16 liter bucket capacity, so you won't have to empty it as much. It has a 3 times bigger tank in half the size. So that is something that I really liked about this. It's very small and compact, but it's still doing the job of what you need it to. You can adjust it to suit your location and what habits you have, whether it be during the day or at night. You can even use the app to dehumidify and preset the water level while you're away, which is very convenient to be able to do all of that from your phone. The filter is easily removed and it's also washable. It's definitely something that I recommend you having in your home. It is really hard to have a relaxing and healthy environment when you have things developing in your home, such as allergens and mold. So I'm really thankful that they sent that dehumidifier over to me, because I have been using it and I've definitely noticed a difference. It's also very easy to empty out by myself. It's not like super heavy. So I know personally, I would recommend picking up a Midea dehumidifier. A huge thank you to them for sponsoring this video. I will have the information in the description box down below if you guys would like to check them out, as well as any important information about the dehumidifier that I may have missed will also be in the description box down below for you guys to check out. The next thing that I think is super important in creating a relaxing atmosphere is having some sort of home scent. I recently have steered away from most candles. I know I have some burning in the back, but I'm really trying to just kind of burn out what I have. I have kind of made the switch over to my oil diffuser lately, just because I feel like there's more health benefits from using it. Definitely do your research and make sure you are purchasing and using high quality essential oils. There's a lot of stuff out there that may seem attractive because it is very cheap. That is definitely something that you want to keep in mind. I definitely don't go for any like cheap essential oils because they can actually be harmful. So you can boost your energy and improve focus with lemon, peppermint, and sage. You can reduce stress with things like lavender oil and also improve your sleep. So there's several different types of oils that will do different things. You can definitely do a little bit more research, but that is what I like to do if I cook something in the kitchen and I want to get rid of the smell. I might just pop in some spearmint. It also, in my opinion, makes me feel a little bit more alert and awake. So definitely looking into essential oils. You guys know I love my Vitruvi diffuser. I will have a coupon code down below if you guys want to pick one up. I definitely think they're worth it. Those are the only diffusers, as well as currently the only oils that I'm using, aside from one other oil that I just kind of got to replace candles, and that's about it. The next thing that I wanted to talk about is perfect for stress relief as well as relaxation, and honestly has made me close to falling asleep multiple times, but I did go ahead and invest in a really nice water fountain. Well, the one that I was eyeing for quite some time went on super sale. So wasn't too much of an investment, but it is still a great item to have. Listening to the water fountain seriously just will relax you throughout the day. It is great to have on in the background when I'm working. It's just something about it is seriously so relaxing. So I would definitely recommend having one of those. I know that there was a really pretty like tabletop one that you could have inside. It was super small and compact from West Elm. Unfortunately, that one did sell out super quickly. So if I can find something similar, I'll link it down below because I have been on the hunt for something a little bit smaller that I can actually put next to my bedside. The next thing that can provide a little bit of relaxation, also a little bit of health benefits as well, is you can actually grow your own produce. It is just a relaxing hobby that you can have. Also, you know where some of the items that you are eating is coming from, and you know that there's not any like harmful additives and whatnot. I personally have been using my lettuce grow. If you guys saw when I first got this, it was just non-existent basically, and now it has like grown and flourished. I truly enjoy taking care of it every week, making sure it has like the proper water, fertilization, checking the water, making sure that the pH levels are where they are supposed to be. So again, you don't have to use one of these. I just would recommend it. It makes things so much easier, but it's just, again, something that is fun that you can have in the home that is very relaxing and peaceful. Next, I wanted to talk about lighting as well as candles. So we'll start off with lighting. And when it comes to lighting, this has been kind of my new favorite light that I have. I personally have been really into mood lighting. This home in particular has a ton of natural light. I have no lights on actually to film this video. So it just in general gets really good natural light, which may not be the case for you. So it is a good idea to invest in lights that they have that will actually produce the same lights to mimic the sunlight. Those are available online and you can kind of do your research to get those, because obviously if you're working from home, you want to have like a well lit space. And of course, research shows that if you have the adequate amount of light, it can improve your mood as well as your energy level, which is super important. You definitely don't want to be working in like a dim lit home during the day. Obviously at night that can be perfect, but during the day that's not something that you want to do. So for at nighttime, I recently have been really into mood lighting. I personally found what works for me, and that is like when it gets to that evening time, I will switch off all of my like brighter lighting if I have any on, and I will transition into a more mood lighting situation. I have this light in particular that I've been using that I just am obsessed with because it gives the perfect amount of just like mood light when it gets later in the evening and it's dark. You don't want to have a ton of bright lights on right before you go to bed. It will definitely keep you more awake and alert, which is not something you want to do if it is bedtime. And moving on to candles, I've actually been getting into non-scented candles and just kind of burning them more for the aesthetic. One thing that you'll find that is a little bit more relaxing are candles with better ingredients. Definitely start doing your research and learn what you are burning within your home. You may not feel relaxed, you may be getting headaches, you may be feeling sick, or you may not feel anything at all, but there are some harmful effects for certain candles, especially certain brands that aren't really looking at the ingredients and they're just trying to come up with a very trendy scent. I personally try and like stay away from the trendier scented candles altogether. If it is the holiday times, I will go for things that already like naturally occur, like pine. The natural scent of pine is just fine for me. I don't need anything crazy like twisted peppermint, marshmallow, whatever, because you know that those are all made with probably a ton of different chemicals. I do, however, like just having burning candles for the aesthetic. I have a few candles now that are just non-scented, very natural soy wax based candles, and I just like to have them burning more for like the mood and the aesthetic. I find that to be more relaxing, but I don't really necessarily need that heavy, overpowering scent. And last but certainly not least is only bringing comfortable items within your home. Now, this is definitely something that I was guilty of a few years back of not doing, because I would see different like furniture pieces or different blankets and different pillows, and I would get them just because they looked good, like for the aesthetic. But when you went to like lay on them on the couch, they were so uncomfortable. So definitely something that I shy away from now. I definitely don't shop that much for pillows that are just gonna serve as decor. I don't really see the need for them. I have this couch, it has the matching pillows and I've been loving it, but I haven't got any pillows other than that on it yet, just because I haven't found any that really are super comfortable and kind of match everything that I have going on in here. So yeah, if you want to have a relaxing environment, you need to make sure that everything you're bringing in your home is relaxing and comfortable in general. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed that video and found it helpful. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.